Part of a choral vespers service from Duke Chapel last fall offers an opportunity to hear an approach to setting sacred texts to music called alternatim, which is Latin for alternately. It refers to a style of performance where a text, often a psalm or a canticle, is divided and performed by usually two disparate groups, such as a soloist and a chorus, or by two contrasting musical genres, such as chant and polyphony. In the case of this service, we are focusing on an example of plainsong alternating with organ music, by Baroque composer Jean-Adam Guilain in his treatment of the Magnificat text from Luke's Gospel. Here are the opening plainsong verses of Guilain's Magnificat on the second tone, followed by the first organ verse. Obviously, the verses played on the organ do not have any text. In some alternatim settings, composers kept the same plainsong melody running through all the organ verses, so there was a clear way to follow the tune and imagine the words attached. In other settings, such as this piece, the composer takes advantage of the colours of the organ to represent the meaning of the words in a more abstract way. French organs were famous for their colourful reed sounds, as we will hear in verse 7, for example, Deposuit potentes, he hath put down the mighty. Guilain uses the trumpet stop to represent the mighty. Jean-Adam Guilain lived from 1680 to 1739 and was a German organist and harpsichordist active in Paris. He was a pupil of the celebrated organist and composer Louis Marchand, to whom Guilain dedicated his collection Pièces de clavecin d'un goût nouveau par Monsieur Guilain, or keyboard works in a new fashion by Monsieur Guilain. He published a collection of organ pieces in 1706, which included 8 suites for use with the Magnificat, 1 suite for each church mode or tone. In the original, there is a simple strophic alternation between organ and voices. To suit our service, we have adjusted the verses slightly. The organ plainsong alternation continues, and the organ represents verse 10 with a lively dance-like verse. Let's hear this and continue into the doxology, the Gloria Patri, which closes the Magnificat with the plainsong melody. To close, we'll hear another movement from Guilain's Magnificat. It's entitled Dialogue, played here as our postlude, with its grand opening introducing a dialogue played on two different manuals to show off the organ's colours.